Hello?
Hey, Coach Morgan. How's the day been going so far?
It's going pretty good. How about yours?
Good.
Good. That's what's up. Hey, what's up, Coach? You ready to get started?
Yeah, I am.
All right, for sure. Will you tell our Back Points Network subscribers your name, how many years you've been involved with the sport of wrestling, and things you got going on right now?
Well, my name is David Morgan, and I'm currently the club director and coach for Wrestling University. I've been involved with the sport of wrestling on, you know, some level, whether that's, you know, competition or coaching or helping other programs or private trainings for 34 years now. Started wrestling when I was 9 years old. We currently have our facility over at 42840 Merrill Road in Sterling Heights.
That's what's up. Corey got the first question for you.
How would you describe your approach to coaching?
Well, for, you know, that's kind of a mixed bag, just depending on, you know, who I'm dealing with and what level of kid I'm dealing with. But as far as just starting off with a youth, brand new wrestler and, you know, guys that have been in the sport for a few years, my approach is a long-term development of that wrestler and, a big emphasis on the fundamentals and, you know, them having fun and having a balance between making it challenging and making it fun. So I would say the main points that I have for young wrestlers is the long-term development and making sure that they want to be involved in the sport and also being competitive in the sport.
In your opinion, what are some of your strengths as a coach?
Well, I think one of the main things is I'm still able to speak the language of a wrestler, speak the language to kids, to youth, to high school kids, as well as college guys. I still have that mentality of how would I like to be spoken to if I was still competing and trying to compete at a high level. Also, just having a approach of it's not necessarily, I guess, rah-rah in your face, screaming, yelling all the time and trying to find that balance. I think I'm able to balance, you know, being tough as well as being sincere of, you know, what we're trying to get across. And then obviously, like I said, having that competitive mindset. And then the other thing, though, one of the main benefits is still I'm able to still get on the mat and wrestle.
That's what's up. Corey, got your next question.
In your opinion, can mental toughness be taught? If so, what are some ways that you teach your youth wrestlers mental toughness?
Yeah, I think mental toughness can be taught. It's also an environmental thing, so it definitely can be taught. Just like anything else, you have to train on that. You know, in the room, in a practice situation with youth guys, it's more of how you're talking to them, building them up. Even though when they make mistakes, you know, it's more the you know, give them praise, tear it down, give them praise again, and making sure that they're in positions to have confidence in what they're doing.
That's what's up. Corey's got the next question.
In your opinion, can physical toughness be taught? If so, what are some ways that you teach youth wrestlers this?
Yeah, so I think those two kind of go hand in hand, mental toughness and physical toughness. I think all aspects of the sport are some things that are learned and taught, and then there's some things that, you know, that you don't necessarily teach that people pick up in a practice room or a competitive setting or, you know, at home or, you know, in their social environment. So with the physical toughness part, it's always a thing of, you know, you want to start off with making sure the kids are athletic. I'm a strong believer that being athletic helps you in the sport of wrestling. So not just necessarily just being a wrestler. So, you know, we do a lot of agilities and rolls and cartwheels and things like that. And then, you know, making sure that the kids have push-ups and and being able to do jumping jacks and just some of the basic stuff that, they need to do. And then as they as people get older, the physical part of wrestling, you know, it's just kind of like an iron worker that you got to get callous and you got to go through some of those things with competition as well as in practice of, you know, short sprints. And sometimes you got to do those long goals as well and continuously putting people in those challenging situations.
That's what's up. Now, moving forward, you know, everybody already is aware of your background as a wrestler. So we want to stay on the topic of your perspectives as a coach, as you've transcended from being a player into becoming a coach. In your opinion, what are some of the most important elements of creating a championship atmosphere for your club, for the youth wrestlers that desire to flourish, for them to be able to do that?
Well, the main thing is, you know, you got to build the trust with the kids that, you know your technique and you know what you're doing, and giving them an environment where they feel safe, that they can come in, make mistakes, get better, work on the techniques that we're doing. And so it's always one of those things that you're on the youth level. And when I say youth, I mean, you know, you got, I would imagine, from 5 years old up until, you know, the high school age kids, of giving them a balance of, okay, it's got to be a fun environment. They got to want to come back. But at the same time, it has to be challenging and it has to be tough. And then also putting them in positions where they're going to have a tough practice and they're going to lose and they're going to give up points and things like that. And then they'll have days where they're their best kid in the room. So just giving them that balance of being able to have fun as well as, you know, develop a tough environment as far as, you know, ultimately when they get on the mat that they can compete for championships and wins and losses.
That's what's up. Now, just on a side note to add to that, just for the sake of our listeners, how long do you think a youth practice should be in terms of the attention span?
And that's going to be on a per kid kind of basis. I've tried to evolve and understand that there's some kids that this is what they do and they want to do on a year-round basis, just like some of the other sports. Then you have some kids that this is a seasonal thing. So it's just a balance of, you know, what type of kids are in the room. I would say most kids' attention span are between an hour and a half to a two-hour practice. Once you start getting above that into the, you know, 2.5-3 hour practices, those are going to be some tough practices for the kids to maintain their attention into what you're trying to get across. So just, and it also depends on what type of practice that you're trying to do as well. But I would say, you know, an hour and a half to 2 hours, a couple of days a week is usually typical for youth wrestlers. And then guys that are looking to do year-round, sometimes those guys can go, you know, 3 or 4 days a week to get what they're looking to accomplish.
That's what's up.
How would you describe the differences between your role as your children's father compared to your role as your children's coach?
Yeah, I mean, there's some differences as far as, you know, being a dad and a coach of the kids. You're always their dad, and no matter what the situation is, you know, I'm always going to be their father and their dad, and working to always be or try to be the best parent that I can, and you know, learn from the mistakes that things happen with being a parent and getting better at that. So that's the number one thing, is always trying to be a good parent to them. Now, as a coach, it's, I think, more up to me to try to balance that, because for them, they're with my boys, are so young. I have four of them, so you know, with all of them being under the age of 11, it's up to me to try to balance that role when I'm in the practice room and try not to bring, you know, any type of situation that we have at home into the practice rooms and try to keep it separate. So it's always a balancing act with that, and then also trying to not you know, push them to the point to where they don't want to be in the classroom with me or be around me. I've also coached them in other sports. So it's just also trying to balance, give them their leeway and their distance. But then also there's times where I feel like that I could give them more on top of what they're doing, but I want them to love the sport themselves. So, you know, it's kind of a tricky situation with that part of it, but it's a balancing act to try to do both.